Hey guys, this is David and welcome back to an all new instrument flying video. Haven't been posting in a while, so I'm sorry about that. Time didn't allow me to do that. But anyways, here I am back and we have a new topic today. It's called BAI. Okay, BAI is short for Basic Attitude Instrument Flying, or BAIF, however you would like to call that. It's a very big part of your instrument rating, in case you're currently working on your instrument rating, or you may have that in mind. Also, if you already have a private pilot certificate, you may have heard of this term already, as a few hours doing your private pilot course is supposed to be related to IFR training. Okay, so it's a big part of your instrument rating, and it's supposed to teach you what instruments to look out for depending on the maneuver you do. Okay, it's something that's rather a practical thing that you can apply in the cockpit rather than talking about it theoretically. But in today's lesson, I just wanted to bring you the two terms of primary versus supporting instruments a little closer. What they're supposed to tell you and basically what they mean. Okay, so that said, there's nothing else to say before we can start that. We'll just talk about two maneuvers. So stay tuned and we'll be back in just a moment. All right, see you.
Yes, hey guys, it's me again. I'm back here and I want to get started on that new topic here, BAI, or Basic Attitude Instrument Flying, however you would like to call that. I'm trying to make this video not too long, as this topic, it's a big one of your instrument rating if you're working on it or if you're thinking about it. We're talking about the full panel, okay, all school six pack, not glass cockpit, okay. And the main thing this video will be about is primary versus supporting instrument during IFR flight, okay? So let's talk about the difference between the two. Okay, why do we have primary or why do we have supporting? Well, primary means nothing else is, depending on the maneuver you do, what instrument are you going to look first at during a certain maneuver, okay? Everything else that support the information of your first instrument you're looking at will be your supporting instrument, okay? Or everything that gives you similar information as the first one you look at is your supporting instrument, okay? It seems a little bit overwhelming for some students, especially at the beginning. Maybe they see a table like this or something in the book and say, oh my gosh, do I have to know all this? Actually, I would say it's really, really simple. You just need to remember your primary instrument, and your supporting, I think, makes sense, or basically almost logical, okay? But I don't want to go too deep into it because this is rather a practical thing that you will get used to doing instrument flight training. Theory is just... It should not be such a big deal, okay? It's something that's rather practical than theoretical. That's probably a better way to put it. Anyway, as you can see, I have that table here. Again, it's a full panel, or we pretend to have a full panel in the cockpit, so all six instruments, okay? That would be your altimeter, ASI, altitude indicator, altimeter, BSI, heading indicator, and the other one, what did I forget? Turn coordinator, here we go. So let's talk about two maneuvers here, okay? First one is not really a maneuver, it's just a basic attitude that we have. And let's say we are cruising at 3,000 feet, or we were instructed by ATC or by your instructor to maintain 3,000 feet, maintain 100 knots, and stay on a heading of 350, okay? So we're supposed to hold that. That would be a straight and level flight, right? So what is our primary instrument for pitch, okay? So pitch information is either nose high or nose low altitude, telling us whether we are climbing or descending, okay? Although nose high does not necessarily mean that we have to climb, okay? That's a different topic again. Anyway, so we want to maintain 3,000 feet. So for pitch information, we want to be looking at the altimeter, okay? And that's the goal we need to ask ourselves. What is our objective during flight? Well, our first objective is to maintain altitude, okay? How do we figure that out? Well, the most direct means of whether we are gaining or losing any altitude is our altimeter, okay? So that will be our primary instrument for pitch, or our first instrument, okay? What about direction? Well, we're supposed to hold a heading of 350. Well, the easiest way to find out whether we are banking left or right or losing that direction is by taking a look at the heading indicator. Okay, so that said, our heading indicator is our primary or first instrument for heading changes or changes in direction. Okay, what is our primary for power? Well, again, instruction word, cruise at 100 knots. So we want to keep that needle as steady as possible at 100 knots. Okay, so where would we look at? Very simple, airspeed indicator. Okay, most direct means of power for this part. Okay, now let's talk about the supporting really quick. Back to pitch, everything else besides the altimeter that will give us an information of whether we are going down or going up, okay, so climbing or descending, will be our supporting instrument, okay, besides altimeter. Temperatures first, and then VSI will give us a similar information, okay. Airspeed indicator could give us a similar information, okay. Usually if we just pull on the yoke or on the joystick, whatever we have in the plane, and we do no power changes, well, usually the airspeed will actually go down, okay, towards zero, the more we pull on the yoke, okay. Attitude indicator as well. What about bank? Well, heading indicator was primary. What other instrument also gives us some turn or bank indication? Well, that would be the attitude indicator, and not to forget our turn coordinator, okay. And what about power? Well, airspeed indicator is our first instrument to look at, and everything else that has something to do with power, in this case our power settings, okay, that would be our manifold pressure gauge, which we don't have in every airplane. It's usually associated with constant speed prop planes, okay, and our tachometer, our tachometer that we do have in most airplanes, okay. Let's go to our second maneuver here, which is a little more specific. Standard rate and level turns, okay? So again, the question is, what is our main objective? What do we want to do in this maneuver? Well, our goal is to maintain a standard rate turn. Again, IFR flying or instrument flying is always standard rate turns, 3 degrees per second, okay? And we'll start with bank here. For bank information, our turn coordinator will give us that most direct indication of whether we have a coordinated and standard rate turn or not. So this will be our first instrument to look at if we take a standard rate turn, okay? Whatever direction we're going to, that doesn't matter. Second thing, level turn, okay? We still want to maintain 3,000 feet. Nothing has changed. So where do we look at? Well, primary for pitch, again, altimeter, okay? Tells us directly whether we are climbing or descending. Primary for power, we still want to maintain 100 knots. Nothing has changed on that part either. So where do we look at? ASI, want to keep that needle on 100, okay? What about our supporting? Very simple, same thing as I just explained before. Every other instrument that gives us similar information to our primary, okay? So, turn coordinator is primary for bank, supporting, heading indicator, attitude indicator, okay? For power, same thing as before, manifold pressure gauge, tachometer. Altimeter, same thing as before, attitude indicator, VSI or airspeed indicator, okay? So, again, guys, this is really simple. Again, I didn't want to make this video too long. Just wanted to explain the big difference here between primary and supporting. So if you know your primary instrument, knowing the supporting instrument is really, really simple, I would say. Just think about what instruments give you similar information to what you have on the first instrument you look at. Okay. Now you can stop that video and read through this part here, change of airspeed in turn. I'm not gonna go through it. And if you wanna check this chart, you can do so by going to my website. That is ifrreview. Okay, I as in engineer, F as in Foxtrot, and then the word review.wordpress.com. But I will put this link at the very end of this video, so that you will have an easier feel going there. Anyway, again, this video was about primary versus supporting instrument from the topic basic attitude instrument flying full panel. There will be some more videos about this topic where we go in the plane and I will show you some maneuvers. Okay, so I hope this video was interesting and helpful to you guys. Thanks for watching, and I see you soon for some more videos on that part. All right, take care. And safe flights. Bye, guys.